We're back, St. Helena, Wine Pavilion at the Napa Valley Film Festival, Carnegie Building. We got Taste Live here, we got Cellar Pass here, we got me here. I'm Alan Croft, I'm the Mutineer. And we have the lovely Stephanie Putnam from Raymond Vineyard, winemaker extraordinaire. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for the invite.
You ready to do this?
I am ready, absolutely.
Well, let's jump right into your strength, which is the wine. What do we got going on in this glass right here?
In terms of the aroma?
In terms of, let's start. Where'd the grapes come from?
Well, this is our 2008 Napa Valley Reserve Cabernet, and this is our flagship wine. And it comes mostly from our estate vineyard in Rutherford and our estate in San Helena, plus some longtime grower contracts that we've had since the 70s.
Okay.
And I like the blend of Rutherford and Cabernet. Rutherford is what gives it the backbone. It's more of a masculine wine. It's got some firmness, meaty minerality. St. Helena is more of a feminine style, sweeter tannins, a little bit more of suppleness. So in this wine, it's a St. Helena that makes it soft and approachable now, and it's the Rutherford that gives it the backbone for aging.
Beautiful. And bloggers and tweeps, get your tasting notes up now, because the answers from the master are going to come here very shortly. But once you get all those grapes, what's the production process on this wine?
Well, fairly typical is that we do a cold soak for four to five days. We do a fair amount of native fermentation, so sometimes a cold soak extends a little bit longer. We do also, I'm a firm believer in extended maceration because I think that really gives length and complexity to the wine. So we do a lot of extended maceration. It's typically around 25 days on skin total. Then the wine is pressed. It's immediately set to barrel. It's roughly 35% new French oak, and the balance is once or twice used French oak. I'm a firm believer in French oak as well.
Wonderful. And what other bottlings do you guys do at Raymond?
We do several bottlings. Under our Napa Valley Reserve, we have a Sauvignon Blanc, which is I call the diamond in the rough. It's my favorite wine. We do a Napa Valley Reserve Chardonnay and also a Napa Valley Reserve Merlot, which is a very serious wine.
Okay. And in terms of what we got going on in this glass, what do you look for when you smell and taste this wine?
Well, this has a lot of vibrancy right now. It's got a lot of black cherry, a little bit of an exotic spice, like a cardamom going on. A lot of vanilla, and there's just a hint of, the wine is almost teasing me, there's a little bit of a candied violet floral aroma. It's a very big wine, it's the 2008, so it has very reminiscent of the 2008 vintage, big vintage, but it's got a lot of structure, but a lot of velvet at the same time.
Wonderful. I look forward to the feedback from our viewers and see if they concur. Now, switching gears a little bit, the wines at Raymond are amazing. And recently you guys have done a renovation, and the estate itself is pretty darn amazing itself. And we mentioned that the folks from Cellar Pass are helping us put this production together today, and you can book your experiences at Raymond for free on cellarpass.com. Can you talk a little bit about what kind of wine experiences you guys are offering at Raymond?
There are many. amazing doesn't even begin to describe the experiences that we have. We have a crystal cellar where you can come in and taste wines, our wines that have been and it's served in a Baccarat decanter, so you can understand what the art of decanting, why you decant, what the process is. Then we have an educational room, our Rutherford room. You can come in and try different appellations, and we'll teach you a little bit about the history of the appellation, the soil, the geography. You can taste some wine, so you really understand what that appellation is about rather than just hearing meaningless words. And then we also have a red room, which is a brand new room for us. It's a member only room, and the only way to describe it is it's a velvet ceiling. It's a little bit like an old English library with a club feel to it. And it's a member-only room. We've created one special wine just for this room called a Raymond Red that we only serve in the room. Oh, then we have our Theater of Nature. I can keep going. There's a lot of experience. Then we just unveiled our Theater of Nature, which is a completely interactive, organic, and biodynamic teaching garden and vineyard. And you can do a self-guided tour, or at some point you can actually download an application onto your smartphone, and you can do a self-guided tour.
It's amazing. And we had our big red carpet party for Mutineer in Napa last week. So we had our whole team, about 20 people, come into town. And the one place that we visited was the Red Room for our welcome meeting, because I'm obsessed with the color red. And it is aesthetically overwhelming in the best way possible.
It's stunning.
And your description was good, but I describe it as Moulin Rouge meets partying inside a womb.
It's, I was like, trying not to go there.
It's amazing. There's like velvet everywhere,
velvet
and the sound,
ceilings,
it's so cozy.
There's two Baccarat chandeliers, velvet walls, huge lounge chairs. There's a pool table, a place you can play chess.
Yeah.
It's an after hours party room.
And as amazing as the wines are, so much of Napa Valley is the experience. It is the context and experiencing those just world-class wines in these world-class venues. So it's a very special experience.
Oh, thank you. What
do you think of the vintages here?
Well, it's definitely a winemaker's harvest. It was, you know, I'm not going to lie, it was very challenging. I've been in the industry for many years. Don't ask me how long. I don't want to date myself. But it was definitely a challenging year. But I think it's a year where I'm calling it a winemaker's vintage, because if you needed to go out there and take everything down to the ultimate nuance, we picked Sunside versus morning side of the vines, because we were trying to get everything when it was as ripe and as ready as possible. So if you were willing to go down to the little nth degree, you made some phenomenal wines.
So the great winemakers with attention to detail, it's really a chance for them to shine.
It's the attention to detail that will showcase the great wines of this vintage.
Nice.
Absolutely.
Let's check in with our omniscient presence over here. Wait, we have someone else. Who are you?
Mike Anderson. I work with part of the marketing team at Raymond Vineyards.
Hi, Mike Anderson from Raymond. Are you going to funnel some questions and comments our way?
Can do. We're actually getting a lot of great comments from everybody.
Let us have it.
So, probably my favorite so far, if I can scroll down here just a little bit, was at Napa Cab. Big, very, very velvety, very juicy, under $40 winning. So that was a good favorite so far.
Is that Charlie Sheen? Is he tuning in
it looks
to
like
the
it.
Broadcast?
It looks like it. It's nice to have him aboard.
Hashtag winning.
Mm-hmm. So everyone is really commenting about the balance. The palate's very, very pleasing. Lots of spice on the back end. Not too many questions, though. I'd like to see if anyone has any.
Okay, we'll give him another moment on that. You mentioned really being a fan of your Sauvignon Blanc. Can you elaborate on that a little bit?
Oh, yes. I call our Sauvignon Blanc our diamond in the rough. It's a little jewel that most people think of Raymond as doing big Cabernets. So people don't really think of us as doing Sauvignon Blancs, but I love this wine. It's a great balance. It has its hints of the New Zealand style, where there's some grassiness and herbaceousness to it, but it also plays with the California forward fruit. So it's a wine that walks the edge of grassiness and white stone peach, crisp acidity. It's all stainless steel fermented. It's a perfect picnic wine.
How do you argue with that? Aging?
Aging. It's all aged in stainless steel because we're trying to retain the fruit and keep the acidity, and it's bottled after about 9 months in stainless steel.
And for those Sauvignon Blancs, what is the shelf life on those for the window of drinking?
I think Sauvignon Blancs will actually age longer than most people think they will. I think our wine will easily go another 5 or so years. Again, it's got good crisp acidity, and I think it's that acid backbone that allows it to age.
You never talk about that, you know? You never hear people talking about aging their Sauvignon Blancs, even a little bit. And
I love older wines.
And what kind of notes develop in those Sauvignon Blancs?
Well, I think you get more of a bottle bouquet, a little bit more of a fig element, a little bit of a nut, almost hazelnut character.
Okay.
And the wine really, the middle palate starts to fleshen out and become much longer.
Okay. More questions, more comments.
It looks like the wine went to Fueled by Tiger's Blood all of a sudden. So
yes, definitely it was Charlie Sheen.
Definitely channeling the inner Charlie Sheen for
okay.
this particular wine.
What was that whole womb comment?
Yes. You went to a place I wasn't quite ready to go with on the Red Room.
Yes. That's awesome.
Like our mouse is having a little technical difficulties with the cold weather. So, oh, here we go. We're back. So it looks like now we have some interest in the Sauvignon Blanc. Very curious to see what that tastes like. Wish we had a little to taste as well, but.
Well, I think you should come to the winery or go out to your local retailer and buy it. I had to get that in.
Yes.
I didn't bring a bottle with me.
And what's the best way to find Raymond wines out in the world, with our viewers being from all over the country?
Over the world. Well, we're in most of your major retailers, all of your high-end restaurants. you should be able to get a glass of Raymond at any place you go.
There you go. Yeah. Last call for questions, folks.
Couple quick questions, as a matter of fact.
There we go.
One, how is the cab age? We had a quick question about aging once again, as well as there was another question about the Sauvignon Blanc.
And you have a great radio voice, by the way.
Thank you.
It's really working for you.
As long as I don't have a face for radio.
Okay, there you go.
So aging on the Napa Valley cab, if we could just go through that one more time.
Oh, I think our wines will age 15, 20 years. I've tasted wines. When I first started at Raymond, we did a vertical. I tasted wines going back to the 70s, and I thought they were all aging beautifully. I don't know if there's a time limit as to how well these wines will age. But if you want to put a limit, easily 15 to 20 years.
There we go.
And one last quick one is we have a question about the bricks of the Cabernet at harvest. Stephanie's favorite.
That everyone loves. I would say our average bricks is probably around 25 and a half to 26 on average. Some are higher, some are lower. It depends on the vintage, of course.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
There we have it, folks. The amazing, wonderful, lovely Stephanie Putnam, winemaker at Raymond Vineyard. Such a treat to have you here.
Well, thank you
for sharing your wine. We're going to come back. We've got more wine coming up from the St. Helena Wine Pavilion at the Napa Valley Film Festival. We're at the Carnegie Building. I'm the mutineer, Alan Croft. We got Taste Live here. We got Cellar Pass here. We're doing this live. We're doing this for real. And we're doing this with enthusiasm. I'll see you guys very, very soon. Thank you so much for hanging out.